Hi guys, let's go for etching. We come directly from the electrolytic copper.
Okay, if I understood correctly. Now we deposit the second copper. We need to remove all the unwanted copper and tin, is that right?
Yeah, in fact, it's a very complex chemical process with three main steps. Let's have a look.
The first step starts with the dry film. All the residue are dissolved and the film is stripped away, leaving the unwanted copper exposed. Then the etching step starts in a bath of a chemical solution. The challenge is to avoid over-etching or under-etching, which would prevent a straight wall from being obtained. As for the inner layer, the uncovered copper is etched away and defines the pattern. Here, the tin protects the copper and the holes. Last but not least, the tin is chemically removed and stripped away. Conductive areas and connections are now properly established. Two checks are carried out on numerous panels in each batch. A laboratory test is carried out to check the over-etching and the under-etching, and to make sure that all unwanted copper layers have been removed, with the exception of the resist layer. The second control is the automatic optical inspection. It is carried out directly after etching and compared with the data to highlight any inconsistencies and guarantee the absence of defects. In some cases, a short circuit or electrical opening can be repaired at this point.
Outer layer is finished. As you saw, it is mainly the same process as inner layer. But now we will go to the solder mask process.
Stay tuned.